Hello, my name is Angela Hernandez, and my educational thinker is John Holt. John Holt was an American educator and writer who was born on April 14, 1923 in New York. His parents were Henry and Elizabeth. John Holt attended Yale University and graduated in 1943. Afterwards, Holt joined the U.S. Navy, and also he participated in the World Federalist Movement in 1951. After his return, Holt began teaching in Colorado Rocky Mountain School with the desire to farm. Holt was encouraged by his sister to teach and only took up the offer at Colorado Rocky Mountain School because the faculty and students grew their own food and helped maintain the school there. At first, Holt worked and observed in exchange for room and board. He later filled in a fifth grade math, English, and French teaching position. And so it was during this time that John Holt became intrigued with the learning process. Holt moved schools from Colorado to other schools in the East after 4 years of being in Colorado Rocky Mountain School. John Holt taught at Shady Hill School, Leslie Ilds School, and Commonwealth School. However, he was fired from all three of those schools, and this was due to his view that testing had detrimental effects on learning. While Holt taught at these schools, he began to observe other classes, and he took notes. His ideas about learning rooted from direct observation of children and his own learning experiences. His notes from observing children in the classroom were the basis for many of what would be his published books. Holt clarified that he only worked in schools in order to answer his own questions on learning and children's intelligence. He never considered himself a school teacher. He believed that the education system did not work. He concluded that school environment hinders true learning. This is because children are given a curriculum, so they have to learn what they are being told to learn. I believe that the school environment created a limited and sometimes boring space for children, preventing them to want to learn. Hall explained that school environment made children feel ashamed or fearful to notice and correct their own mistakes. He strongly believed that children should be given the liberty to explore and choose their own subject matters that they find of interest. Second, Hall believed that schools prevent the natural desire for children to learn. This is because he believed in the idea that children are biologically driven to learning. Therefore, schools limit the child on subject matters. Holt suggested that a child is curious, wants to make sense of things, and wants to find out how things work. And a child will figure out and learn from their own mistakes. However, schools prevent that by giving children the solution. Schools teach children what they want them to learn, and children then replicate what they have learned. However, children are not actually learning on their own and figuring out the subject matter as Holt describes they would by being biologically driven to that. Third, Holt believed in the idea that if schools could not be changed, then parents were better off taking their children out of school. And his book, What Do I Do Monday, was considered to be a voice for the radical school reform movement. Holt attempted to show how children can benefit from active participation in the learning process. However, after almost a decade of advocating for school reform, Holt concluded that the American school system has changed very little and will probably not change by much. After this, Holt had basically given up on school reform and established the idea of a new education order where there would be a new path to learning instead of one school path. John Holt made an impact in education, especially through his published books. His book included his 1962, How Children Fall, which dealt with his teaching experience in Boston. This book was the beginning of school reform. Hall, in this book, insisted that children in America fail in school because of the fixed body of information and distrustful of the interest of children. His second book, How Children Learn, continued the idea for a calling on radical school reform. His third book, The Underachieving School, addressed educational practices of testing, grading, and fixed curriculum. His fourth book, What Do I Do Monday, was Holt moving into a position of offering suggestions on how to make school systems better. His continuing books, Freedom and Beyond, Escape from Childhood, Instead of Education, Ways to Help People Do Better, Never Too Late, a musical autobiography, and Teach Your Own, a Hopeful Path for Education, where Halt's continuing works to address school reform, education system, and alternative forms for teaching. All of Halt's books were influential in developing teacher training programs, and the books helped raise important questions about the American education system. Halt being the prominent leader for radical school reform has left the movement that is still happening today to make the schools system as best as possible. Second, Halt influenced education by developing the idea of unschooling. He wanted children to explore the world around them. Unschooling is the concept that a child will learn how and when he wants to learn. The child is given the liberty to control his environment and teaching skills. In parts of the world, it is acceptable and allowed. However, children in America are obligated to obtain education. Therefore, Halt advocated for homeschool movement. Homeschooling has become popular as individuals who dislike the teaching techniques and environments from school systems teach their kids at home. Homeschooling carries the same implication of teaching children, but instead it's done within the home, allowing children to gain some control over subject matters. Halt had many critics for his ideas, especially among his first book, How Children Fail. Many educational and academic communities were offended and disagreed with Halt's view. Susan Douglas Franzos of the University of New Hampshire took a critical look at Halt's philosophy of education in her article, The Best and Whitest Parents, A Critic of John Halt's Philosophy of Education. Franzos recognized Halt's work and ideas, but believed that Halt's advocacy of a single solution to the multiplicity of problems we now face in education is naive and misleading. She also believed that Halt's conservatism ultimately sanctions the education neglect of the majority of children. I think personally that Halt's ideas of homeschooling is not acceptable. A child must need guidance and help. However, homeschooling is a more acceptable approach to an opportunity of more freedom for subject matters while incorporating a schooling approach. This finalizes my presentation for my educational thinker, John Halt. Thank you.